Oh yeah, so in clubbing news, this is from the techno subreddit. For those of you that I'm not on it, please subscribe. It's a really great subreddit. I'm on it all the time. Talks, loads of stuff about the techno scene and usually loads of Berlin news as well. That's always good to hear because I'm missing Berlin and I want to go back so badly. But I've got other things I need to probably worry about more than going to Berlin right now. But hey, ho, an interesting thread popped up on the techno subreddit titled "Berghain Warning About the Cherry Pill." This is from an Instagram called Berlin. Berghain Line Live, which I just discovered now. I didn't know it was an actual thing. So somebody sent in a DM to them and said, "Hey, someone who's working at Berghain just told me not to buy red pills with cherries on it because they're highly toxic and would be nice if you could spread the warning." So there's a bad batch of pills going around. And someone asked a really good question on the comments, right? That I've always wondered. Here's a question. I don't expect the question to be answered, but if you never ask, you never know. Who runs the drug trade in Berghain? It would be, have been monopolized, no? Russians? Because I've wondered that too. Because when you go to the Berghain, you're obviously aware that people in there are taking drugs and stuff, and you might go in and purchase some from people in there too if you're that way inclined. But again, it's a very sensible and grown-up approach to taking drugs. I remember a friend telling me once when they went there. And they didn't know what was going on, and they tried to take a bump on the dance floor. One of the club goers told him, no, don't do that here. You go to the toilets, right? You don't do it on the dance floor." Like, told him off, whatever. And then when you go to when you, and then he told me when you go to the toilets, people are very well behaved. Everyone's in line waiting to go into the cubicle to do their drug of choice, right? They're not, in London, you'll see people in bars and clubs not being bothered to wait to go into a cubicle and just taking a bump quickly as they're waiting in line, which again, fucked up for everyone because you're not respecting space. If a security comes in, guard comes in and finds you taking a bump in line, they're gonna then it will make you start busting down the doors, and everyone kind of gets everyone gets it because of your kind of recklessness. So people are very well behaved in Berlin for the most part, and it's odd as well, especially in the Berghain. It's odd because it's a place that you'd think would be rife for people to be to not be well behaved, right? Because it's just hedonistic central, right? Lights, darkness, pounding beats, people in flipping skimpy outfits, dark rooms that people are getting up to all sorts of nonsense, right? You'd think it'd be the prime platform for just, sloppy behavior, but it's a complete opposite. Everyone is so well behaved. There's people just sitting down, just listening to tunes. There's people just standing next to the wall and just closing their eyes and feeling the vibe. People just chatting. There's a really weird, sensible vibe about the Berghain in general that it's really weird to kind of wrap your head around, right? It's very, 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 very bizarre. But I've always wondered too about the drug scene in there, like how do they regulate it? Because I would imagine, again, having not read the comments properly through, but I would imagine they would be really strict on who kind of sells in there, right? And not have any big dealers there, because most of the time, most clubs have, a dealer that they kind of veto, or they're allowed to come in and sell under the guise of just being sensible. Don't take the piss. Don't kind of flame us up. And if you get caught, you can't snitch, kind of thing, right? That would be the kind of premise around it. But that kind of agreement will invite competitors, will invite people to come in and take chances, will invite some sort of confrontation. Because imagine if a kid comes in there and tries to sell some stuff, and the dealer sees, he might think he's stepping on his turf. There's ample room for stuff to go left in that kind of scenario. But I would imagine if you ran a club, maybe the best way to do it is to kind of completely outlaw it, right? Say there's no monopolizing of it, but also stress that your punters and your visitors just be sensible and not take the piss, right? And just kind of look after each other. That's the main thing that you see a lot in Berlin. A lot of looking after each other, make sure everyone's okay, not you're only as strong as your weakest link, blah blah blah, right? Because it, like that whole affair fabric when kids were dying, like two kids died because taking bad pitcher pill bad batch of pill bad batch of pills, and fabric's kind of approach to it and the conversation around it was a little bit disingenuous, a little bit disrespectful. Someone that I don't know, I would feel really uncomfortable if I was the owner of fabric and two people died in my nightclub and I just continued operating it. I'd want to close, you know what I mean? It doesn't make sense in that regard, right? Especially considering how strict they are on the door. They have sniffer dogs and metal detectors with that malarkey. They go over and beyond, and then still you have people in there selling shitty batches of drugs and shit. There's some culpability on the owner's side, I think, in some way, shape, or form. But I like what the Berghain have done, because some guy commented and basically gave a little bit of insight into how it happens and why it happens. So This person replies and says, giving an upfront. Nope, actually, it's not monopolized at all. The securities are tough on dealers and will call the police on whoever they catch. For years, there have been rumors about official dealers in Bergheim, but I've been a regular there for 7 years now, and I'm pretty sure I would have seen one of those officials by now. In fact, quite the opposite is the case. It's part of their unofficial deal with the police to keep an extra eye on Russians and Arabs in order to prevent any form of organized drug trade inside Bergheim. Wow. Awesome. As long as the drug trade is not organized, the club won't have to fear raids. Source, DJ who plays there regularly told me. Okay, that makes sense, right? So if you invite a dealer in, or you have an agreement, unofficial agreement with an organized crime syndicate to deal drugs in a particular nightclub, you are susceptible to that organization being under the watch of the police watching where they deal, finding out one of their dealer deals in the club, and then your club getting raided because they think you're culpable in it. And of course, you know, once a club gets raided, has there ever been a nightclub that's got raided that's kind of survived the raid, like post-raid? There's always a little, like, it kind of comes building, going, it reopens, but it never quite comes back the same. People kind of get scared off of it a little bit, right? Is that a thing? I'd imagine so, right? It's sort of the same sort of thing when someone gets fired at work. And, you know, then you know they've been fired and no one talks to them, right? Because no one wants to stink on them as well. They've got the mark. They've got the cross on them. I'd imagine the same sort of thing happens with police raids. I'd imagine so, right? No club really survives that kind of level of scrutiny, because I'd imagine it will impact your opening times, your licensing agreement, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. And it continues, you'll mostly find small fry dealers inside, just ravers from the scene trying to finance the hedonistic party life. Many of them are regulars, and if the securities know your face, they generally treat you better. When they catch you and they know you, they might look the other way or give you a heads up that they're onto you. But if you ignore the warning, they will call the police on regulars too. So I like that, right? Everyone gets treated the same throughout. I think there's a story too I saw recently about a DJ getting banned from the Bergheim for a similar sort of thing, right? Like partying too much, just getting a bit too crazy behind a booth. I forgot who it was. There's a particular regular Bergheim that got banned, that's not allowed to play there anymore. And I think reading the story, or reading between the lines, it seems as if they have a very broad kind of, and again, that speaks to the success of that organization in general, right? Forget them as a nightclub, think of them as a company. It speaks to the success of the company that everyone gets treated the same. There is no exceptions to the rule. If you're a friend of the club, respect the club still, or you get chucked out, which makes sense why people, if you've ever been outside the Bergheim, you see, you know, some of the regulars that get VIP guest lists, like hugging the security guys and the door people. And it's a really warm embrace. It's not like the fake sort of like London kiss on the cheeks to kind of keep appearances. It seems like they've got a real deep connection with them. And there's also a tinge of their being so grateful on the person that's coming in, being immensely grateful that they have this opportunity. They have this, you know, this luck of knowing who they know to kind of get in first and kind of jump the queue. They're really appreciative of it, right? And you get that feeling, and it must be because, you know, they are aware that if they break the rules, they're out. There is no exception. Doesn't matter if you know the owner, all that sort of stuff. There is no exceptions there. And I guess, again, it speaks to the success of the club. And I think, like I mentioned earlier, that DJ got basically excommunicated from the club because of some, actions that weren't, respected by the owners and stuff, which is, you know, again, something that I really, really fully respect 100%. But yeah, now we know, innit? No organized crime syndicates run the Bergheim. It's all decentralized. They're very strict. If you take the piss, you get chucked out.